back to Open Line tonight. I'm here with Councilmember Fabian Bednay, who is behind a proposal, an ordinance in front of Metro Council that would basically tie incentives that we offer companies who are thinking about moving to Nashville to money that goes into the Barnes Fund, which helps with affordable housing in our city. When we talk about affordable housing, we're talking about housing for people like firefighters, for police officers, for teachers. We're not talking about Section 8 housing right now, but affordable housing in this city. We had Joanna call in who didn't stay on the line with us, but she just said, I'm one of these low-income people who feels forgotten by this city, and that really is heartbreaking.
It is.
And she's not alone.
She's not. I remember my first time that I ran for office, I was knocking on doors in my district, mm-hmm. which is a middle-class district, and I will find people living in terrible conditions. And I thought, this is the way they live in other countries. This shouldn't be happening in the U.S., in Nashville. So I think many of us, because we get in the car in the garage.
We have our bubble.
Yes.
Yeah.
And so we don't see that there are people that we share the city with mm-hmm. that are living in conditions that are really tough.
Yeah.
And now, some people say, well, it's their fault. They should take care of it. But it's really not a good way to look at it, because people, you know, could have been in a really good place. They get very sick. All of a sudden, they have to go pay for treatment, and then all the money they had to do repairs mm-hmm. to the house, they can't do anymore because they have to take care of their kid that is very sick. I had actually the one case of one person that in Bordeaux that I helped. His son had developed cancer, and his house was falling apart, and he had he asked for help, and I said, sure, what can we do for you? Can you fix my front door? That's all he wanted, so he will be safe in the house. So it's not that people want to get a free ride.
Right.
People just want to have a minimum decent opportunity. And it's most times the people I found doing this work are just good people that mm-hmm. life happened to them,
yeah.
and now they need help.
Yeah, oftentimes it's, you know, but for the grace of God go I. And we just need to think about that. Let's go to Monique, who is on the line. Monique, thank you for calling in.
Hi.
Hi, go ahead.
Okay, I wanted to know, how is the calculation done to know exactly how many people are moving here per day or per month?
Mm-hmm.
And also, I've always heard of we have so many people moving here per day. How do we know how many people are actually moving out? I've never heard of, we have so many people moving out of the city. Mm-hmm.
That's a great question.
And I'd like to know if that's even possible.
Okay.
Thank you.
No problem.
That's a great question. Mm-hmm. She's right. I have seen a lot of people moving out of the city because they can't afford mm-hmm. to live here. I don't know that anybody has quantified that, but I think it will be probably a big amount of people. What the numbers we hear is that about 100 people moved to the Nashville region, what is called the MSA, which is the Nashville and the surrounding counties, every day.
Mm-hmm.
But some people that live in Nashville, they can't afford to live here, so they'll move to surrounding counties. Because in Woodbine, for example, in 1 year, property values went up like 50-60%.
Wow.
So somebody could afford mm-hmm. to rent there, they can't anymore, so they will move to Laverne mm-hmm. or other places. So it'll be an important question. I think I appreciate the question. I'll look into that. Because
I do wonder. I mean, there is probably a little fudge with those numbers.
Mm-hmm.
That, you know, that person who was in Englewood then moves to Antioch. Is that one for Antioch, but we didn't take away from Englewood?
And I've
also heard births factor into that number, into that 100 people a day number.
Mm-hmm.
So it's not somebody always coming from out of state and planting here.
But I think anybody that drives on Owens Road will say that we do have a lot more people in the city. I remember being able to drive across the city much faster than what I do today.
Yeah.
So
when I was interviewing for this job, my news director said, this used to be a 25-minute town. You could get from one side to the other anywhere in 25 minutes.
Yeah.
Now it's an hour almost.
I used to live in Madison and work in Brentwood, and I could do it. Now I wouldn't be able to do it anymore.
No.
I think they will find me dead in some part of 65. 65.
They're sitting on 65, just wasting your life away. Yeah, but you know what? That's a reality for a lot of folks who have been pushed out of the city's core.
Yeah.
They can't afford to live here. They have to drive in an hour sometimes. And you think about all the time that takes away from your life, from your children, from your spouse, from just enjoyment.
But it's also connected to affordable housing because a developer friend of mine, we were talking about affordable housing, and he says, you know, what people do now is they drive till they qualify. So they'll drive out of the city and they keep looking for a place that they could afford, and that's where they'll live. So it doesn't have anything to do with where they would like to live. It's just where they can find the first place that is closer to the city, to their job, that they can afford to rent or to buy. And that's not a good policy. That's not a good way to deal with things because, for example, it creates all this terrible traffic.
Right.
If somebody before didn't need a car but now needs a car to go to that job, that, you know, so
same
it just
job.
Adds more cars to the road.
And you don't think that this is just the price of a growing city, that this happens everywhere?
Oh, it happens everywhere, yes. But we are at the point that we really should do something about it. Because it's just going to get worse in terms of the impact on the quality of life. So issues of helping people stay on those homes, dealing with transit issues, dealing with all these things, they're all connected. So I think I always tell myself failure is not an option, right? We all want to live in a successful, equitable, wonderful Nashville that we grew to love, and we just need to find a way to keep as much of that as possible because this is what we call home, right? This is a place we love and we want to continue enjoying living here.
You talked about this has gone through the first reading, which is the formality. You've met with the budget committee, which brought up some great ideas. Maybe some revision is needed. For folks who are listening at home right now and say, yes, yes, I'm behind this. This is a great idea. What is the future of it? What kind of timetable?
Well, tomorrow at the council, I will defer for one meeting to give time to make an adjustment. Mm-hmm. And I'm going to be I'm going to ask the council members at the before I defer to give me feedback if they have any ideas. But I also ask the people that are watching the show, I know many people are watching it, to just reach out to me and to give me their ideas. My email is on the council website. I'm the District 31 council member. I'm open to suggestions on how to make it better. And if they like, just email your council member and tell that council member to support it because they want to do what is right, and you will help them by telling them what you think to do what is right. So I think this is a great council. I'm very proud to serve with them. They all want what's best for the city. And we have a deliberative process of talking about the issues, and so I'm excited about the next month to see how, you know, we improve this legislation.
Do you think this could get the final stamp, perhaps, in a month or 2 months?
I will hope so.
Okay.
But I think we need to do something. This is one thing about this legislation. I never expected it to resonate so much. I finally thinking, well, this is a technicality, a small thing that we really should be doing, and it just took off. I mean, people have been very excited about it, and I was actually happily surprised that it resonated so much. I think we need to talk about equity. We need to talk about all the different ways in which we are failing and we're leaving people behind, and it's important that we look at that, not only on this legislation. Even if this legislation passes or doesn't pass, we need to continue talking about equity because that's what people want. People, they think that we only care about the very wealthy, the big corporations, about downtown. It is not true. We care about the whole city. We just need to start legislating in a way that puts that into action.
Yeah. We have to take another quick break, but Mike and Ann, I know that you were on the line. After this break, we're going to get right to your call, so please stay where you are. We're coming back.